Hey everyone, it's Dr. Sam Robbins. Today I've got a really important topic, and it's about cholesterol levels, whether it's too high or too low, and how it's linked to erectile problems and low libido and low testosterone and hormonal imbalances, also of course heart attacks and memory problems and just accelerated aging and pain and much more. Now, a little over 20 years ago, both my parents had high cholesterol levels and were given statin cholesterol lowering drugs, the popular ones you've heard of. And I discussed this in a video at my website, which I'll give you the link at the end of today's video. Now, back then, I had very little knowledge about this topic, unfortunately, and I admit to it. In fact, most of the research and the doctors knew very little other than high cholesterol is very bad and lower it as much as you can. However, over the past 20 years, because of my parents and all my patients and clients, and all the newest research, and by not listening to most physicians and all the marketing and hype, I've learned that the topic of cholesterol and lipid levels is actually very complicated. However, the good news is that I've been able to simplify it down to the basics. So here it is, pay attention. First of all, very high cholesterol, obviously over 260 and for sure over 300, isn't good for your body, all right? It causes the damage of the arteries and blood vessels, it causes erectile problems, memory loss, and of course can lead to a heart attack or stroke. However, very low cholesterol, maybe even 140 or lower, especially when artificially lowering it with statin cholesterol lowering drugs, can be even worse for your health. In fact, it's clinically linked to diabetes and high blood sugar levels and also high blood pressure. It's linked to lowered testosterone levels and hormones for both men and women and lowered libido levels. It's for sure linked to memory problems and being forgetful and Alzheimer's and Parkinson's. And yes, again, even low levels are linked to a heart attack or stroke. Thus, you want balanced, healthy levels right in that middle part, not low or high. Lastly, there are many other indicators that are even more important than total cholesterol levels, such as your HDL-LDL ratios, the particle size of the LDL, that quote-unquote bad lipid cholesterol levels, the homocysteine levels, your triglyceride levels, and also your liver health, where 80% of your cholesterol is made from internally and not from the dietary cholesterol you eat. And so I don't want you to forget this. And of course, many other lifestyle factors, you know, what kinds of foods you eat and the exercise and stress, sleep, and the biggest one, and pay attention, it's genetics and your hormones, which obviously your hormones change as we get older. However, I bring up this topic because I get a lot of people, especially men, telling me about their problems. And many times after digging around, asking lots of questions, I see that cholesterol is one major factor they haven't even addressed or even thought about. Which is a shame because cholesterol is needed by every cell in your body. Remember, cholesterol is required to make so many of your hormones. Thus, why low cholesterol and using these harmful statin cholesterol-lowering drugs are linked to so many health issues for both men and women. Again, I dealt with this with both my parents. And doctors just blindly and stupidly prescribe them to everyone. Hey, your cholesterol is high, take some drugs. Then over the next few weeks, months, and years, people start to complain because of these drugs and with so many additional health problems. And guess what? This is great for both the prescribing physician and the pharmaceutical companies because the patient keeps coming back and they get prescribed more and more drugs. And this time, not only for cholesterol, but also blood pressure and blood sugar and pain and erectile problems and sleep problems and anxiety and depression and more and more. All of them, in fact, link to cholesterol problems as one common issue and the use of these horrible cholesterol-lowering statin drugs. Remember, genetics aside, your hormones control how you look and feel. So if you're dealing with any of these issues, especially if you're over the age of 40, then you need to stop and think about your cholesterol levels and your lipid levels. Obviously, you know, if they're really high, you need to lower them back to healthy levels. And please, I'm begging you, do not use these toxic cholesterol-lowering statin drugs. I went through this with my parents. Both of them used it for about 6 months, and it aged them like 10 years. And it does the same to so many other people. They don't even realize it. They just accept it as part of life. Please, don't be like other people. Don't accept it. All right. You can improve your levels naturally and live a much healthier and longer life and feel good both physically and naturally. There's no drugs needed. I've done this so many times. And remember, your focus should not be just to improve your cholesterol levels, but also to improve your, again, HDL-LDL ratios, the particle size of your LDL, your homocysteine levels, your triglyceride levels, and liver health, where remember I stated 80% of your cholesterol is made in the liver, not from the dietary cholesterol you eat. And again, I cover all this in a short video about my parents and also that convenient, easy solution they've been using for over 20 years. So get all the details below in the description area. Go ahead and take a look at that right now while it's fresh on your mind. Thanks for listening and have a happy and healthy day.